What's up? So it's hard to believe it's been 30 years ago when Milli Vanilli were the most dominant act going in music at the time for their time. And what's so amazing when I think about Milli Vanilli, I was thinking, wow, the cats that were behind them, the producers, they put the voices to the faces to the voices, and it worked. That was ingenious, actually. Because Girl, You Know It's True was a bump. That was a bump and cut. Now, Milli Vanilli got exposed for lip syncing. How I miss those days now, because now you have these mumble rappers. You got turkeys who can't even talk on cue, let alone rap or sing on cue, and are stiff. And you look at Milli Vanilli, they have dance routines. It's pitiful and it's embarrassing, but see, I blame that on the racism and also the music industry, which allowed and fostered that in. And I had a nice reminder of that the other night. I was watching that Billboard Award show at the end when Paula Abdul got out there with her non-singing behind. She was a bad choreographer, could dance her butt off. She couldn't hold a note if it was full of water and you in the ocean. She still found a way to sink. I'm like, man, it's just a reminder. But yeah, they pushed Milli Vanilli out there. They put that out there. That tells you how this industry done, some real shady, shysty things to cheapen stuff. It was lip syncing, it was sampling, and then ringtoning. They've done everything to throw and to manipulate things. Now, the thing about it with Milli Vanilli, I'm like, well, people weren't going to get their money back, and they got that, they had to get their Grammy back, but who cares? The industry had already known. And you think about this is one of my flashback videos, by the way, but telling you, if they can, funny thing, how they used these two cats to, which worked, the record sold a ton of records, you know, but it shows you how the industry does what they want to do if they can get away with it. And it was a good hustle. It got over. Even though the CDs and stuff would skip on stage, and eventually they got called out. They had a perfect elaborate scheme. And Clive Davis was behind it. Yeah, I called him out because he's on Arista Records. But see, this is how it's going on with this business. So they do stuff like that. So you're just thinking back to the Milli Vanilli scandal 30 years ago. But really, how much of a scandal really was it? Because you've had ghosts in the studio. We know Jennifer Lopez got ghosts. Her non-singing behind. You know, there's a lot of them. That have had ghosts in the studio, they've done more than what you know. But they sell that image, they brand that product. So Milli Vanilli, in a way, was a precursor to your brand because you could be a no talent hack. If you think about it, Milli Vanilli predates Paris Hilton, all that, and the Kardashians, all that, because if you got the face and the place, you brand it. Now, I said the songs was cool, even though they didn't bring nothing far as actually singing to it per se. But that was pre-branding, if you think about it. That's something to think about it. Milli Vanilli scandal from 30 years ago. Because if you had something like that today, I wonder how that would play out. I wonder if people would even care how the music gets pushed and what's pushed around because if they brand so much and manipulate so much. It would be, might bring for an interesting story. All right, so that's my reminding the rewind of Milli Vanilli from 30 years ago, the Milli Vanilli saga and scandal. Looking back. Feel free to leave comments, hit the subscribe and the bell rings. That's a new video. I'm out for the day. Peace.